Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, the missile man of India and the 11th president of India, was born on October 15, 1931. He was born into a middle-class family and lived on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram, a city famous for its temples. When the Second World War was just over and India awaited the freedom eagerly, Gandhiji declared, "Indians will build their own country." The whole country was filled with an unmatched optimism. Kalam secretly wished for a chance to do something for his own country. For this, he thought, he needed to study in a good school, but he never dared to ask his parents, for he was born into a middle-class family. Even if his parents were economically backward, they sent him into a good school in the town. When he was a young boy, he was once beaten by his maths teacher for entering another class by mistake. He was crushed, but from that day, he made up his mind to be the best student. He studied night and day, and his dream of scoring high mark in maths came true. He was so thrilled then, and the next day during assembly, the same teacher, the same math teacher who had punished him earlier, called out his name and said, "Whomever I punish becomes a great man." And he said, "This boy is going to bring glory to our school and teachers." His words came true in the history. Kalam and his friends used to sit by the side of a pond in their village when they usually came back from school. While his friends practiced skimming pebbles over the rippling water, he would sit and watch the cranes and seagulls soar in the sky. The sight of flying birds inspired him, and he dreamt of his future. As he grew older, he realized his area of interest and opted for engineering. He joined in Madras Institute of Technology, MIT. He studied hard to win the scholarship. When his college boasted of two aircrafts that were on display, he used to sit near them. He was fascinated by the design and wanted someday to create an aircraft like that. He was asked to design a fighter jet with a team of four members by his professor. When his teacher checked the project, he was disappointed and rejected the project. Kalam pleaded with him. Professor gave him 3 days' time and said, "If you fail in this, your scholarship will be cancelled." The scholarship was his lifeline. He had to keep on working. He remained awake all night and day, even without taking any food. On the last day morning, when he almost completed the task, he found his professor peering at his drawing, and after examining his work, professor patted on his back and said, "I never expected you to do so well." He got his scholarship and also graduated from MIT with outstanding marks. He was always dreaming of flying like a seagull, which later came into realization as the missile man of India. In 1979, it was finally the time for launch. Kalam and his team had worked hard for the last 7 long years. They were all waiting for this moment. They waited anxiously as SLV-3, India's first satellite launch vehicle, was prepared for the launch. The first stage performed to perfection. They stood spellbound watching. Their dreams were soaring in the form of SLV-3. Suddenly, the second stage went out of control. and the flight was terminated after 317 seconds. The rocket crashed into the sea and all their hopes drowned with it. They were left with hopelessness. It was a big shock to them. He was angry and frustrated. While the press conference was scheduled to discuss the causes of the failure, he felt responsible for the crash. He was sure that the press would blame him and his team. But his chairman, Professor Satish Dhawan, took the mic and answered all the questions confidently. He said, "These are very complex missions. We have to find out what went wrong and correct it." And he added, "In a year's time, we can successfully place a satellite in orbit." These words gave him the energy to soar again. Exactly 1 year later, in July 1980, the whole nation watched them again. SLV-3 lifted off and the satellite was successfully put into orbit, and he got the opportunity, which he says the most important words that he had ever uttered in his life. They are: mission director calling, all stations, all stages performed successfully, and the Rohini satellite is now in orbit. This changed the future of Indian space program. The whole nation was excited. India has made its entry into the small elite group of nations that possessed satellite launch capability. His colleagues lifted him on their shoulders and paraded around the launching pad. It was his proudest and happiest moment. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam is always an inspiration to everyone. He inspires young minds and he motivates students. He tells us to dream, dream and dream, and to work harder. He said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world." And on July 27th, 2015, the most inspiring soul, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, while delivering a lecture, died of cardiac arrest. He didn't even allow the nation to have an off day on the day of his death. Instead, he set the whole nation to work on the day. Here are his lines for everyone to start a day with. Tell yourself every morning, "I am the best. I can do it. God is always with me. I am a winner. Today is my day." If you are new to this channel, please subscribe, share, and comment.